Right, enough talk about all of those silly expensive graphics cards. Let me show you something that's a lot more accessible. Alienware's pretty epic little gaming monitor. The screen behind me is surprisingly affordable. It packs in a 240Hz refresh rate for super smooth gaming. It's got FreeSync, G-Sync compatibility, the works, which makes it an awesome little package that will work for pretty much anyone, assuming you're a gamer. In this video, I'm going to walk you through absolutely everything you need to know about this Alienware AW2521HF, its pros, its cons, and ultimately why you might want to buy one. But first, meet the MSI GE66 Raider, perfect for both work and play. This epic gaming powerhouse has it all. Crazy fast NVIDIA RTX graphics, Intel's 10th generation gaming processors, and a sky-high screen refresh rate of 240Hz. This is insane. Style it your way with bespoke RGB lighting on both the keyboard and laptop body, and then play anywhere thanks to incredible portability and the maxed out 99.9Wh battery. Learn all about the MSI GE66 Raider with that link down below. The Alienware AW2521HF then. This is a monitor that you lot all told me to review, and so here we are. In a nutshell, this is a super fast 24-inch gaming monitor that is highly suitable for a wide range of gaming PCs and gaming use cases. It is remarkably well built, like seriously. Alienware just crushed the competition on this one. You've got an absolute tank of a stand that looks ace and is highly adjustable, and there's even subtle RGB lighting that's more complementary than garish. It looks rather nice actually. It's also FreeSync rated, yet it's G-Sync compatible, so no matter what graphics brand you currently have, be it AMD, Nvidia, or who knows in the future, maybe even Intel, you're in no way locked into any particular graphics brand here. The thing that I really love about the Alienware though is just how scalable it is. Normally when we're talking about gaming monitors, they do tend to carve themselves quite a unique niche, like you have to be this sort of gamer that plays these games and you want to play it at these settings. And while that is definitely true a little bit with this, not so much. I think if you had like an £800 gaming PC, you'd probably enjoy this monitor just as much as if you spent £2,000. There's a lot of scalability here. I think as long as you're actually going to be playing games on this display, it is going to be suitable for you. So let's drill a little bit deeper into gaming then, and we'll start with our competitive stuff, Apex Legends and Fortnite, and they both excel on this screen, with a 240Hz goodness allowing you to reduce the latency and your reaction time, which truly unlocks your full potential. Games not only feel smoother, but that added connection that you get to the game will indeed make you a better gamer. And make no mistake, it is going to give you a competitive advantage. But having said this, while it feels fantastic and 240Hz, if you can get it, is just awesome, the main problem is that some games are just too intense to get a constant 240 frames a second. Esports titles are always going to be easier to drive, with things like CSGO being a prime candidate for this screen, but even with an RTX 3080 and an i9 CPU, Horizon Zero Dawn capped out for me at around about 130 frames a second, which leaves a lot of unused performance on the table. And yes, I can hear you now screaming that Horizon Zero Dawn is about as well optimized as your first ever traffic system in a game of City Skylines. Nerdy joke for you there, I knew you'd like that one. But the point is that CPU limitations very much do exist. So if you're wanting to pair this with a very high-end GPU, do bear in mind that if you don't have one already, you're going to have to upgrade to something like an i9 or a Ryzen 7 or Ryzen 9 to probably get the most out of this. It's not essential, like obviously it will still work and you'll still be getting very high frame rates, but if you're really wanting to get near that 240Hz in everything you play, you may well need to think about this. So yeah, your super affordable ultimate 240Hz gaming monitor might actually get a little bit more expensive if you need to make some PC upgrades. But assuming that you can already get that full fat experience though, or you're playing stuff that's a little bit lighter, it is well worth it for the competitive players amongst you. I'm telling you, you will play better with something like this. But the story isn't really the same with single player games, as obviously they're fantastic at high refresh rates, but in terms of your enjoyment, I wouldn't really say it gets much better after around about 120 frames a second in my opinion. It's very much a story of diminishing returns, as lower latency is great for multiplayer, but doesn't really make your single player experience any better. Which leads me on to the main trade-off, I guess, that you're going to get if you do decide to go for the Alienware, the resolution, as this is 1080p Full HD. Which is absolutely fine. Nothing more, nothing less. It doesn't look bad, but it doesn't really blow you away either. images just look pretty good. And yes, it is absolutely a lot easier to drive than a Quad HD display, but the more prettier titles, such as Horizon, just don't look their best, with a little pixelation that you've probably forgotten about if you're used to gaming on your 4K TV. The same can be said for the outright image quality. Absolutely fine, I don't think you're gonna have any big complaints, don't expect to be blown away. Perhaps all of this sounds a little bit negative, but you've gotta be realistic about your expectations. And besides, this actually opens up the door to speed. And speed is good. As long as you're going the speed limit, of course. Fast action looks crisp and blur-free, with sharp visuals and then minimal ghosting. Will it make a difference to all of the games you play, net you that premium experience that you're no doubt looking for? And look, here's the thing. 240Hz monitors are absolutely nothing new. I've been covering them for quite a few years now. But they've gone from something that has become quite niche, something that's not really that accessible, to them coming down in price, to the graphics cards becoming more powerful, better CPUs, and all of that stuff has also come down in price, which now means that 240Hz gaming has gone from something that's quite hard to recommend to something that is actually quite easy to recommend. Obviously, the RTX 3080 and even the RTX 3070 are quite expensive, but all of the cards that are to come are gonna be a whole lot cheaper, they'll be more powerful, we've got new Ryzen processors, and then of course we've got 120Hz console gaming to think about. You couple this with the fact that I've now actually had plenty of time to play at 240Hz competitively, and I just get it. So sure, this monitor still isn't for everybody. If you play mainly single player games, or maybe you want something that's big, it's ultra wide, HDR, any of those things, it's still not really gonna fit the bill for you. But if you are a gamer and you play multiplayer games more than you play single player games and you wanna play fast, well, this is for you. And I'd wager that is a lot of people. I really hope you've enjoyed this video though. If you have, please hit that like button. I'd love to hear from you as well. Let me know what you think of the Alienware. Would you go for 240Hz? And if you do want to check out current pricing, you can with my Amazon affiliate links listed down below. And of course, while you're down there, don't forget to check out MSI's epic GE66 Raider. If you're after a gaming laptop that does just about everything, with a ginormous 99.9 watt hour battery, then look no further. With up to GeForce RTX 2080 Super graphics, Intel's latest 8-core gaming processors, and the super fast and super responsive 240Hz display, you'll never need a desktop again. Get the very best of PC gaming on the go with MSI's GE66 Raider. Check it out with that link down below. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Would love to hear from you, and I'll see you in the next video. Watch them, there's more in the end screen. That's what it's for. Click it, I dare you.